For everyone just tuning in right now, we have the two leads for this brand new movie that you guys can watch on I Want TFC. It is My Lockdown Romance. Jameson and Joao are in the house. And so let's talk about this movie because, you know, watching the trailer, it's actually pretty cool. You know, like I know Gab, I love the chemistry that all of you guys have together. And so I want you guys to talk about this film really quickly. Like, you know, what was it about this film that you said, yes, I need to do this because I totally fit the character?
Well, yung character kasi, it's pretty similar to me in terms of his attitude. I mean, maybe traits, personal yeah. traits. And the thing that made me say yes to the project was I just decided that I wanted to try something new. I wanted to try a new role. And yeah, syempre, as actors, you know, we have to like explore, you know, grow as an actor. So that was the main thing that made me say yes, because I wanted to try something new.
Yeah.
For me, well, for me, what really attracted me the most was the story of the movie, because it's the setting is during the pandemic.
Yeah.
And well, the character itself, we actually had to audition for our roles, and luckily, our personality and everything is very similar to our characters. So that was good. But for me, like, what attracted me the most, like, was the story. Dahil, you know, it's nangyari sa amin dito ngayon eh, lockdown lahat, wala kami magawa. You know, we're all on just, you know, talking on our phones, talking with our friends and stuff like that. We've experienced some lockdown romance also, you know, try to flirt a bit, you know, talk to your ex or stuff like that. So it was the story was very relatable. So yeah. I guess that's what attracted me the most.
That's pretty cool. Now, I heard that you guys kept this movie a secret for a while. You guys were kind of working on the under, didn't really tell anyone about it. What was it about this film that you guys didn't want people to know?
That's how it really works. Like, you know, when there's like a new project, we don't really say anything yet until
yeah. right away.
You know, when you feel like it's right, you know. So we don't really want to, like, you know, I mean, we just wanted to keep it, you know, private muna and like keep the excitement, you know. So yeah. that's how it usually works. But after every project, I mean, while we're doing the project, we like, you know, keep it a secret first, and we'll bit by bit would, you know, give out some teasers, you know. So
yeah. And then when you guys did release it and finally was able to announce it, like, what was that feeling like when people started to gravitate and started to really feel what you guys were doing?
Well, I was happy naman, because like I know there's some fans out there na waiting for me to do something like this, because after my first movie, you know, it was also LGBT themed, and they were just waiting for me to be, you know, play a role, you know, differently. So yeah, I think some of the fans are happy.
That's cool. What about you, Joao? Yeah,
I was happy and excited because, you know, we've got a project that was shot during the pandemic, and, you know, mm-hmm. we wanted to show it to people. And I was really excited for them to watch it also, because I'm pretty sure that they can relate to it so much.
Yeah.
And at the same time, it's something new for me and Jameson, since we're doing this like coming of age film. So the fans really like the idea, and they were all like, yo, Joao and Jameson, they're doing a film together, yo, they got chemistry, you know, yo, we can't wait to see it. So yeah. So we were just excited for them.
Now, the one thing I didn't know about this movie is that you guys actually helped film it. You guys filmed this movie from your homes with the guidance of the production team on a Zoom call. Now, what was that like? Yeah. You know, because now you're not just an actor. Now you're like, you're a camera guy too, and you're trying to do everything that they said. So
one man show.
Yeah, exactly. So describe what that was like. I mean, obviously, because that was a different challenge for you guys during that time as well.
Well, the first day was the most challenging because I was by myself. And Joao wasn't there in the first day, but then it was me and Gab, and I was by myself with the camera, laptop, and then I had to do everything. Like, I mean, typically what we would do every after scene would, like, you know, memorize our lines and stuff like that, get dressed for the next scene. But then that time you were like, you know, setting up the lights, you know, the audio, and basically everything. I even remember one that first day. We had to shoot the refrigerator, and it was filled with vegetables and fruits and everything. It was filled like everything. And the director told me, "Oh, we have to. That needs to be empty." So you know, I looked around. You know, nobody's here. So all right, one by one. It was a lot. It was so many. And like you know, I just realized I was so tired. But then you know, it was a good learning experience. Sometimes at least we kind of got the idea of like how it works behind the camera.
Yeah. What about you, Joel?
True. Yeah, same experience with James. And first day is always the hardest because we're like still testing out the waters on how to work with it. You know, since there's no cameraman, no lightsman, no art department, so you have to do everything yourself. So yeah, it was hard in the beginning. We did workshop spot on how to set up the camera,
wow,
or how to do the settings and stuff like that, where to put the light and stuff like that. But luckily, with the guidance of the production and the director, they were so patient and like nice with all of us. So it was a struggle in the beginning, but then sooner or later, once we got the hang of it, it was fine. Like we just keep on going.
Yeah,
it was fine. But at the same time, like yeah, what Jameson said, it's a struggle, but moreover than that, it's a learning experience because we got to learn how to set up the camera, the lights, and we can actually use that in our future projects or even with whatever we have.
I was going to say, like, you know, there could be some future producing, you know, roles for you guys in the near future. And you could do everything on your phone nowadays, you know. So,
true. Yeah, true.
I wanted to ask you guys. So on paper, you know, the premise of this movie is about two good friends in college who reconnect during the lockdown. But I want to get your perspective. Like, if someone were to ask you, you know, I've heard about this brand new movie that you guys are in, you know, can you tell me about it? So how do you explain, you know, what this movie is about to people who ask?
Well, I can just say it's a love story during the pandemic. So I think it's relatable to a lot of people, especially a lot of people during the pandemic, you know, maybe, you know, trying to enter a relationship or, you know, hoping someone will talk to them, you know, some instances like that. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, basically, the story being during the pandemic, you know, I think a lot of people will relate to it.
Yeah.
Same, all right, Joel. For me, I guess I would say that our film, My Lockdown Romance, is a light-hearted film about friendship, about love, and about the lockdown. You know, this movie, I'm pretty sure this movie is super relatable because it's happening to us right now.
Yeah.
And it just talks about two close friends, and it talks about their friendship, their feelings towards one another, and how everything is just also affecting them and just them in general. It's just like really what we are experiencing right now. So yeah.
And that's a pretty good point about what you guys are experiencing. We do have a mixer question that asks this right here. You both had lockdown romances. Have they seen the movie? Did it help that you were inspired in real life?
That's a good question.
Wait, is that a question? Or because they're like saying like we had like you both, or are they saying like an example?
I guess an example, because I guess you guys are, you know, you guys had or have relationships during lockdown, right? So I guess maybe you can, how does that, I guess, correlate to the movie, you know?
Well, yeah, obviously.
Relationships are like family relationships, but I'm gonna.
I like how you're keeping it safe, Jameson.
Yeah,
now.
Yeah, well, okay. To be sure. Like,
come on, Jameson.
True. Well, for me, obviously, we're all humans here. You know, we would talk and like flirt a bit and stuff like that. But yeah, I've had my lockdown romance, and it did help out. You know, with me in the film, because it's exactly what I did in real life. Like what I did also in the movie. So it was just super, super relatable. Talaga. So there was no struggle there.
And see, Jameson's keeping quiet because he knows there's a part two of this movie coming, right?
Wow.
My Lockdown Romance part two.
Maybe.
All right.
Oh, wait. Should I answer?
Sure. Go ahead.
I don't know. I can't. Because like, I didn't really get the question at first. So
This is a safe place, Jameson. Safe place.
Right. Nobody's gonna hear us, right?
All
right.
No one's hearing us.
Lockdown romance. I don't really have one, but then, you know, it did help me a lot. I can't give it so much detail, but then it was okay. Because like, what I realized then during the pandemic is, you know, like, it's a great time to reconnect.
Okay, so for everyone watching right now, if you drop a Yamashita or even a Malacanang, maybe James will tell the full story of what he's hiding right now.
What? Full story.
Check it out.
It's going to take an hour here.
Yamashita, let's go.
Shout out to 1,100 viewers. There you go. Drop that Yamashita, but Jameson can tell the whole story.
All right, so I wanted to ask you guys, you know, obviously doing this film was a little bit different from what you guys were used to. You know, you're not on a set, you know, you're in the comfort of your own home. You know, maybe describe how this changed for you guys. And then even the dynamics, you know, like, because typically you would work together in person, you know, doing a movie. So this time it was very isolated, very different. Mm-hmm. Maybe describe what that experience was like.
It was different. I mean, yeah, it was challenging and different at the same time. The part where, you know, how like we're so used to like acting in front of each other in person, mm-hmm. physically, but then when we shot this movie, you were acting through the screen, and yeah, it's not as, because like, you know, when we're acting, we have to get some hugot, you know, some
mata, yeah.
Parang ganan, you know, get some,
that's,
you know,
true.
Inspiration. Yeah, parang ganan, you know what I mean, right? So, but then yeah. Screen, so it was kind of challenging, but then yeah, we just had to trust each other and like, mm-hmm. Say our lines and I mean express their emotion like how we do it in person. So yeah, that was the only part that was challenging.
Yeah, that's what true. I agree with Jameson. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, obviously it's a struggle for all of us, but at the same time it's a learning experience, since we understand now the people also behind the camera, because usually we're just the ones in front, but now yeah. we understand the people behind the camera and how things work. Like, we appreciate them more and we appreciate the work that they do for us. You know, it's not easy. So yeah. there's that. And then struggles, again, what Jameson said was acting, not being there physically together, because that's what we used to do before, pero ngayon it's just through a screen, through Zoom lang. And yeah. It was a struggle for me, because back then while we were shooting the film, I didn't have a proper Wi-Fi here. So like, they would send me this prepaid Wi-Fi and the signal wasn't that good. So there were times talaga na we're acting na and it's kind of like heavy, or like, you know, we're getting into the zone na. Like, it just chops off, it cuts off because I'm delayed or walang signal. As in mahirap, pero luckily we were able to pull through it. And yeah, like what Jameson said, we just had to trust one another, you know, with our acting, with the emotions that we have to portray.
So, Joelle, this is a quick question for you. I'm getting a lot of questions to ask you about your neighbor, Inigo. Yes. Did he help you, you know, during quarantine?
Inigo Pascual is my homie. He's a brother, man. Like, during the quarantine, in the beginning, I felt so sad because I'm an extrovert. I really like to go out and like hang out with my friends and stuff like that. But then when quarantine happened, when the lockdown happened, I was like, yo, what am I gonna do now? Like, I was just sad. Like I had no Wi-Fi and anything, talaga. So I was just like, what am I gonna do? Luckily, Inigo's like a brother of mine. Like, he would just tell me like, yo, yeah, just come up, just chill here, man, if you want. Yeah, you can use the TV. Like, I would go up to his place, eat, and like even sleep there sometimes. Like, he just lives above me. So yeah. I would just like go there, play his PS4 to like 4 a.m. in the morning and sleep. But then he helped me out a lot during our audition phase, because again, I didn't have Wi-Fi. I didn't have a good signal. So yeah. I didn't want to get embarrassed during auditions, you know, like have a choppy signal. So I would text Niggs, like Nick, I call him Niggs. Niggs, bro, I got an audition for a new movie. Do you mind? Like if I come and stuff, like, no, bro, it's fine. Yeah, just come up. Just come up anytime. So like, Inigo plays a huge part in my audition phase.
That's pretty cool. Now, that's a good question for both of you guys. Like, how did you guys keep the motivation going, you know, with everything going on? I mean, we're all locked down, you know, like you guys both said, you guys like to kind of be around people, or, you know, just getting that inspiration, you know, while working. How did you guys work together and to motivate each other?
Motivating each other during the shoot,
during the shoot, yeah.
I don't know. There we were just like in the,
there was one in the beginning, Jameson, where because initially we weren't like partners yet, like we didn't know who our partners were. But when we realized now, oh, I'm gonna be with Jameson, and then oh, Jameson heard it like I was gonna be his partner. Like from that on, palang we were like, yo, since we're friends, that since we know each other, like yo, bro, let's do it. Let's help out each other. Like we don't. Like the chemistry is there, nakase. There's no awkwardness now, you know. We don't have to break dice in anything. So I guess that was one of the motivations for me. And then other than that, we were motivated because, you know, we're lucky to have work during the pandemic because we were quiet for quite some time during the pandemic. Yeah. Say, you know, with everything that's happening, na postpone yung mga projects namin. So I guess we were happy and grateful na may trabaho kami. And it's a new experience for us, you know. That's one reason also. It's something that we've never done before. It's a new role that we've never done before, and we're doing it with each other, which makes it so much better because we know already one another.
Yeah
pretty much that.
Yeah.
And we were just helping each other during this. I mean,
true,
like with every scene, you know, I like try to like help us, I mean, help each other with the lines and stuff on how we should say it, you know, so we can just like, you know, make the viewers feel the connection.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so also in this film, I mean, we didn't really talk about this as much, but Gab was also in this film, and I call her Pinsan, she calls me Pinsan. But what was it like working with Gab, you know, because she's kind of like the third person in this whole entire you know, scenario. You know, what was it like working with her, and especially again, it's, you know, the distance, you guys weren't physically seeing each other. You know, was it challenging to do, or, you know, was it pretty easy going?
Well, most of, I mean, all of Gab's scenes were with me. And why are you pointing at me?
No, it's because she just worked with you. I've never worked with her, diba? She's your best friend, kasi.
True. So, like, he doesn't have any scenes with her. So, yeah, it was fun. She's funny. Like being, and she played her role very well. Like being, you know, the best friend and stuff like that. Speaking out for me. So yeah, it was funny. It was funny, and it was also nice meeting her.
So, what do you guys have to say about it? Because I told her when I talked to her earlier, I was like, I'm gonna ask them about you and see what they say. So, what would be like one thing you would say about Gab?
Gab's amazing. She's super friendly. That's one thing I really like about her. She's super friendly.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think we've met in person yet. No, Jameson, we've never met.
Yeah,
Gab,
I don't
in
think
person
we've. Yet. Yeah, we have.
Not yet. Yeah, we've never met Gab in person yet. So we can't wait to meet her in person and like actually hang out and get to know her much better.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. All right, you guys. So for everybody tuning in, you guys are seeing Jameson and Joelle. They are on the movie that you can stream and watch right now on the I Want TFC app. It's called My Lockdown Romance. You guys definitely have to watch it. I'm going to do that tonight after we're done with the show today. So I'm going to make my wife watch it with me and be like, we got to watch this film. It's pretty funny.